Getting ready to do some bee maintenance. Got to fix that warre hive. What I'm going to do, I'm going to basically convert it over to a langstroth. And then I'm going to put a warre box on top for them to draw out comb. I'm actually surprised they made it through winter, to be honest with you. But they did, and now I got to fix what I messed up last year. So basically I'm going to swap the warre bottom board and the warre boxes for a langstroth bottom and another langstroth deep.
Thank you.
Hopefully they figure it out. They usually do. I was trying to see if there was a queen in there or something, because they are really interested in this box right here. I think it's just where her pheromones are on there. So once that dissipates, they'll start looking for where she's at and they'll find it. That wraps that one up. This one I think is a dead out, but there is some activity, so it might not be. Not a good sign when your fondant jar is full. No bees at the top. So I think what's happening is the bees that are actually going in this are probably just scavenger bees from somewhere else. There's a small cluster there. Oh, there's a lot of dead bees. These are Saskatraz, by the way. I've never had good luck out of Saskatraz. That's a whole lot of dead bees. These are the ones I thought were dead out. going to put that fondant back on there. And then check them in a few days. Leave these other boxes off. Those spare boxes over here where they're easy to get to. Now the one that's right next to this Saskatraz is rocking and rolling and has been all year. So all I want to do to them is give them some sugar syrup. Probably ought to give them some smoke too. I don't think I've smoked them since I've been here. Takes care of these guys. And I'm going to take and switch their entrance around also, since I'm here. Takes care of them. On these, I just want to feed only. So I'm going to let them know that I'm here. crap around here. Basically going to do the same thing on this one. Just going to feed them. Clean up some stuff here. And I put these entrance reducers on back in the fall, and I'm going to leave those on until probably second week of March. Same way with here. Now, one of the things I forgot to mention is what I'm feeding them with is just a straight sugar syrup, but it's got brood builder in it, and it's a DIY brood builder that not only helps them encourage creating new brood, it also takes care of some common early spring diseases like Nosema and that sort of thing. So it works really well. It basically just uses some household oils, like essential oils, and it's got some mint and stuff like that in it. I'll leave a link up in the top right of the video to the recipe for that. It's been used for years and years and years by a lot of beekeepers.
Again, this is mostly just a get the bees fed type deal. Probably ought to go ahead and get their entrance also turned around a little bit wider. I don't want it to be too wide, but I also don't want it to be so restrictive.
And that wraps us up.